नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट दिस सब्जेक्ट बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग यूनिट नंबर 4 इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन्स। द मेजर टॉपिक इज सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर। द सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर और अल्टरनेटर इज एन इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन दैट कन्वर्ट्स द मैकेनिकल पावर फ्रॉम प्राइम मूवर इंटू एन एसी इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर एट अ पर्टिकुलर वोल्टेज एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी। इट रन्स ऑन कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड कॉल्ड सिंक्रोनस स्पीड। It is widely used to generate constant voltage output, hence it is used in power plants. Advantages: constant speed operation, good power factor, reliable, high efficiency. Applications: salient pole generator is used for low speed of about 1000 rpm. Salient pole generator is used in hydropower plants, that is also due to the low speed. Cylindrical rotor generator is used for high speed of about 3000 rpm. Cylindrical rotor generator is used in thermal power plants. This is based on the high speed. Classification. Depending upon the design of rotor, there are mainly two types of synchronous generator, namely salient pole type synchronous generator and cylindrical rotor type synchronous generator. The construction is very well explained by this diagram. You can see there are so many parts, among them stator, rotor and exciter are the main parts. Construction wise, an alternator consists of filled poles placed on the rotating fixture of the machine, that means on rotor. The filled poles are made to rotate at synchronous speed. This synchronous speed is given by the equation Ns is equal to 120 F by P for effective power generation, where F is the alternating current frequency and P is the number of poles. It is installed with a stationary armature winding and rotating field. This modification is made to cope with the very high power of the order of few hundred megawatt. To accommodate such high power, the conductor ways and dimensions naturally have to be increased for optimum performance. For this reason, it is beneficial to replace these high power armature windings by low power field windings, which is also consequently of much lighter weight, thus reducing the centrifugal force required to turn the rotor and permitting higher speed limits. Now, the construction of salient pole type rotor. You can very well understood by this diagram. The term salient means projecting or protruding. The salient pole type of rotor is generally used for slow speed machines having large diameters and relatively small axial lengths. The poles are made of thick laminated steel sections riveted together and attached to a rotor with help of joint. To prevent the oscillations, the damper winding is provided on pole faces. The damper windings are generally copper bars short-circuited at both ends are placed in holes made in pole axis. When the alternator is driven at a steady speed, the relative velocity of the damping winding with respect to the main field will be zero. But as soon as it departs from the synchronous speed, there will be relative motion between the damper winding and the main field, which is always rotating at synchronous speed. This relative difference will induce the current in them, which will exert a torque on field poles in such a way as to bring the alternator back to synchronous speed operation. Salient pole alternators driven by water turbines are called hydro alternators or hydro generators. Now, construction of cylindrical type rotor. This is very well explained by this diagram. The cylindrical type of rotor is generally used for high speed machines and employed in steam turbine driven alternators like turbo generators. The machines are built in a number of ratings from 10 MVA to over 1500 MVA. This type of machine has a uniform length in all directions, giving a cylindrical shape to the rotor, thus providing uniform flux cutting in all directions. The rotor consists of a smooth solid steel cylinder having a number of slots along its outer periphery for hosting the field coils. The cylindrical rotor alternators are generally designed for two pole types. The cylindrical rotor type machine gives better balance and quieter operation along with lesser windage losses. Now the working of synchronous generator. The synchronous generator operates on the principle of electromagnetic induction. This is nothing but the Faraday's law. The synchronous generator has a stationary armature and a rotating field. The rotor is rotated by using a prime mover. When the rotor rotates, the stationary conductors are cut by the magnetic field. Hence, EMF is induced in the three-phase alternators. The rotor flux will induce three-phase voltages displaced in a time by 120 degree EMF induced is AC in nature. AC voltage will give rise to AC current when a load is connected to the stator. Friends, you have any query regarding these topics, you can mail us on avin.kanani@darshan.ac.in. For more details, you can visit our website www.darshan.ac.in. Thank you.